Are you looking for work? Hi, my name is Slavika Bogdanov. I'm a business and personal coach for the last 10 years. I'm also a serial entrepreneur. I have many businesses. I'm a best-selling author and also a public speaker. So are you looking for work? Are you really looking for work? Do you really want to find a job? Well, I want to share with you 5 tips that could help you find your ideal job. I come across a lot of people that are looking for work. I also, when I put advertising to find people, I receive a lot of different emails. And I see a lot of mistakes that people make that cost them the opportunity of having a job. So I want to share this with you so that it can help you and enlighten you if you're looking for work, the things to do and also not to do. So tip number one, find or go search for jobs where you are actually qualified and have some experience. Sometimes I receive CVs, resumes from people that are looking for a sales job, but the resume has nothing to do with sales. So it's a waste of my time. It's also a waste of your time. So before you apply for a job, look at the specifics of what the job requires and actually apply to the jobs that you have some experience in. Once you do apply for a job, change and modify your resume so that it really points out the places where you have experience that correspond to the job you're actually looking for, searching for. That is quite important to do if you want to get employed, evidently. And also for us, when we are looking at resumes, we receive a pile of them. So if we open a resume and see that there's absolutely no link between your qualifications and what we are looking for, it's immediately garbage. I receive a lot of people that are applying for a job and only say, "Hi, I'm really interested about your job, and please call me at," and give me their phone number or their email. No resume, no letter of intent. And that is really like catastrophic. You're sure to never, ever get a job doing that. So make sure that you send your resume, that your resume corresponds to the qualifications or the experience that is required for the job. If you do not have those experiences, move. Get your butt moving and start learning more. Search for information so that you do acquire more knowledge and more experience in that field. Secondly, write a letter that either in the email or if you're mailing the letter, then write the reason why you want to work in that particular field for that particular employer. And what makes you different from all the rest? So we receive a ton of different emails from people who are searching for employment, but they all seem to blend and be the same. So if you're able to really stand up to be different, to show what your unique selling proposition is in terms of your experience or your motivation or what qualifies you, if you talk to the business about their business, telling them, "Well, you know what, I've seen that you are very good in whatever," and you actually give qualities of the employee or information that you actually done some research about the employer, that is a lot of bonus points for you, because we're going to notice, oh, wow, this is not just someone that sent 200 different resumes to 200 different companies. He actually or she actually took the time to research about who we are and what we represent as a company. So that is really important. Write a couple of paragraphs to really show why you want to work for that company and how you can really add value to that company. Thirdly, well, be proactive. Don't just wait that, you know, an employment offer just comes, falls on your lap. Be proactive and send your resumes to companies, even if they didn't put an employment out there if they didn't put an ad. You never know. Sometimes there's internal jobs that are, you know, searched for and not necessarily advertised. Sometimes you might just fall just at the right moment where people were thinking, should we hire, should we not? And you come right at the perfect moment. So be proactive. Use also original ways to be noticed by the employers you want to get hired by. Okay, know exactly who you would like to have as a boss or what company you would like to work for, and target those companies proactively. 4, use social media. Be on LinkedIn. Develop a great profile. Go talk to the social media, either your friends, or develop new contacts through social media networks to actually get a job. Be careful on what you put out there in your social media, because employers do look at your profile when they're ready to hire you. And if they see naked pictures of you or you being drunk every day, might not be positive for your being employed. And 5, please remember to be prepared for that first call and second call and third call until you get that job. I get people that, you know, set an appointment with me for an interview on the phone, and when I call them up, they're in the car, they're driving as they're talking to me, you know, red light, they're all panicked. Don't do that. Be sitting at an office desk, be ready mentally, be prepared for the interview, know what you're going to ask, know what you want also from the job, know how you're going to also demand or ask for different things that you would like, maybe a different salary, how you're gonna ask for the hours that you're gonna work. So you can also modify what the requirements of the jobs are, and maybe add more value for more pay. So that's also a tip that can help you. So it's not because the salary is there that you might not get more than what is offered. So that's also important to know. So I hope this really helps you to know what to do to be hired. It's been a long time since I was on the job searching. I'm now an entrepreneur for more than 10 years. But I've dealt with a lot of people that are looking for work, and I've coached thousands of people. So I, as a coach and also as a entrepreneur, I know that a lot of people do a lot of mistakes that are costing you your job, your salary, and your future. So if you want more information, please log on to this page and join my live training that will happen for a few weeks, where you will learn how to create a proper CV, how to have a unique selling proposition, how to write your letter of intent, how to present yourself, what to say, what not to say, how to modify the conditions of your employment. This course, this training is really good for people who are either looking for work or for people who hate their job and want to change their jobs. So a lot of things that you need to know, because it's very, as you know, it's very competitive out there. And you need to be different, you need to think differently, and you really need to stand out if you want to have the job of your dreams. And I really hope you do, and I'm here to help you achieve that goal in 2016. So please register to my live class that will really help you to get there faster and get what you want, because that's the most important thing, not get any job. Get the job, the one that you want, and so that you can have the pay that you want, negotiate the pay that you want, and also evidently stay there and be happy in that work environment. So thanks for joining me. Also, that training will have question and answers, so Q&As, where you will be able to ask me live questions. So that way you can get also the answers that are more specific to your particular needs. Thank you.